So topics would be, what is the success and the obstacles? And another topic would be repetition on the four stages of violence I noticed from practice and how it's working. So for the new viewers, my name is Krunos Albaraba. I'm 42. I live in Krat in Cambodia. I'm practically a refugee from Croatia in a way. And first I'm going to talk about the classical first four stages of violence. First two stages are emotional, third stage is emotional and mental, and the fourth stage is emotional, mental and physical. So first stage is the ridicule. Violence begins with the ridicule. It's emotional, people simply hate you, and or they hate your race or appearance, or they simply feel like a shit with themselves and they need to feel good, and the only way for these kind of people is if they ridicule somebody else and verbally attack. And I live in Cambodia. In Cambodia they have the culture of bog, which means plus, and it's cultural thing. That means they are deriving the feeling of a bond or plus among the group if they attack or ridicule other person. It also means a group rape as well. So in this culture there is actually a term which is very positive for that kind of behavior. Believe it or not, cultures are different from culture to culture. Here is violence, okay. So then you have a second stage, which is the insult. So first, this is like Farangchkaya, which means white dog or cracker and so on. Pal, get lost, Niakam Puchea, our country. So this stage is also, but it's also very happy. First two stages are very happy. They are really laughing, and culturally it means that they are just having a good time and there is nothing bad going on. And no, people around them not gonna see that as a rude thing. Of course, they don't wanna be a subject of their ridicule. This is because if you notice Asians, they try to be always in a big group, precisely because this is how they behave. And if you know Chinese or their languages, you will notice that they are extremely rude, because this is how they treat weaker groups. And in their philosophy, which is Buddhistic, those who have more are automatically spiritually better, and that they can bully others. This is really how they reason, okay? So, I could also go into that, but I don't have time. And so this is that thing. So then you have the third stage, and third stage is a crucial stage. And I'm just gonna compare it with America right now. You have now Black Panthers, which are publicly talking that they need to start killing crackers or white people. This is the third stage when they're rationalizing the hate. This is a psychopath within the group, and of course, within the case of Black Panthers and all groups like KKK and so on, of course that you have reptiles literally running the show, and then they have their mind-controlled slaves called Illuminati around them, and then you have psychopathic personalities and borderline psychopathic personalities as a flying monkeys, and then you have applauding hands, which are the general public. And then you have people like me and many of my viewers, TIs, which simply said that's a bullshit, we're not buying that. Okay, so I'm explaining you system, how it works in little bits and pieces. So that psychopath gonna now rationalize why they need to hate me. And in the case of Cambodia, Mark Tudor for our next digression. In Cambodia, they... of course, I'm white, I'm 42, I'm fat. They started immediately CIA, Farang, white guy, army. And this is how psychopaths start to scare the group. Oh, you know, he's dangerous guy. Now, let me give you the digression from Tudor, from the theory. Master Tudor, master narcissist, his books are really to read, and his lectures. He is a narcissist, and he's in a very eloquent and extremely intelligent way describing how they operate. Very important. So he goes, you normal people, you must have everything in categories. So if you see old lady talking to herself and feeding pigeons, she's witch, she's crazy. If you see old guy in a black coat with a black umbrella during the rain in front of school, he's maniac, he's rapist, he's pedophile. And all we need to do, my kind, and he says, my kind doesn't suffer from that. We know that what we see is not what it is, because this is how they operate. They are psychopaths, they are narcissoid, okay? So all what our kind needs to do is to reinforce that false belief in you, and that's it. We just reinforce it, it's already there. So this is how they play. They see black guy, he's a criminal, he's gonna rob something. That's it. This is how it works. And more they reinforce, more they repeat, people more believe. And then they trigger the defensive mechanism of the group. Now they need to defend from you. See, not only themselves, but the whole country. And this is when they enter the panic mode. And I've seen it, it's ridiculous. I've seen the panic mode. I've seen like only mother is standing under the house, you know, 12 pillar houses in Cambodia. Father is running to me, then he's running back to her. Children are running left and right, and they're running back under the house. Dogs are doing the same thing, two dogs. Everybody in the panic, and I'm just passing. You know, Taveng, deep, sorry, not deep province, but, you know, civilization came there like 15 years ago with the first NGOs, you know what I mean, to teach them to dig a hole and shit there. I've seen posters. So, not to shit on the ground, because that makes them sick, you know, that level, okay? So, so you have that, okay? And this is how they play with human minds. I gave you like the worst example, but you immediately understand the idea. So in your life, I'm really begging you, for your spirituality and for many TIs, when a little bird comes and start telling you that somebody is boogeyman, whoa, make some rational and adult distance and emotional distance from that, because that might be psychopath smearing somebody big time. And this smears, and now I'm just gonna talk about the school. Now we go back, when I said smears, now let's go back to school. Oh, every time I worked in Asian school, I was going through four stages. First stage is you are one of the best. I'm one of the best. I just enter the school, start working, start figuring out their particular system. Boom, I'm one of the best. I just learned how to work in their school, and now I'm perfected everything. In the meantime, smear campaign. What I exactly described before. Oh, with his big feet, he's stepping on a little children. He's drug addicts. He smokes marijuana, but they don't use this term. They use term meo, which means basically drunk and intoxicated in any sense, you know. and I'm just working even better than when I was one of the best. And then I start noticing people who look like that, you know, I mean, you have like you're, and this is what Yogi, my friend from Hawaii, knows very well. He made contact with somebody, somebody starts liking him, after a couple of contacts, that person looks like that. Three little birds come to him and oh, I didn't know that he's a vampire. And so this is the smear campaign phase, and the third phase, you're fired over nothing or something very little. And then comes the fourth phase, I'm hired again, or they want to hire me again. Because those who've been impressed by my work and didn't complain about me, now they suddenly ask, where is that guy? He was great. And we need great teachers. And we need teachers in general. So, hey, what was that all about? Oh, that was about bullshit. You know what I mean? And that happened twice, okay? And I figured out the system, how it works. Now when you know quite a bit of the theory where I am, just give you one more example. I've been waiting for this contract to be signed by the local authority more than 2 months, so that I can open a bank account in a local bank. And this was the third version. And I'm not sure if the landlord lady paid any bribe, but in short, so about success, I cannot open a school. I have an area where I could like open evening classes easily. It's a very big area. Let me open the light in the big room. You have the idea. Can you see the end? So I could do, I really wanted that, and I have enough money to buy like basic equipment. Thing is, I simply do not have enough money for bribery. For legal bribery and for the illegal bribery. And these are like thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars. So speaking about the success, finally, what is your success? Is your success your own success, or your own success to the infrastructure of your country? Somebody build like roads, like electricity, all this stuff you take for granted in a first world, in the second world where I'm from, like Croatia, and you know, the post-industrialized countries which are now in debt. So you have that. The second thing, all the social infrastructure, like nobody's asking you for a bribe when you want to open a bank account or anything, nobody's stopping that. If you take that for granted, just wait a minute. You know, there are countries where it's impossible to do that, and there are countries where it's difficult to do that. And Now, only that obstacle is coming from the system, from the reptiles and their stooges. Well, maybe that's not your problem, but it's my problem. And then, what do we have then? Okay. Then we have the money to start the business. Now, imagine that. You have that. But you come off these obstacles. So, is this your failure? Or you simply are in the category of underprivileged? No, even in the subcategory of underprivileged, of the target individuals. That's even worse. So, what is a success? My friend from the 1990s, Katarina Borčić, very cute at that time, she told me definition from theological, I think, faculty. She was studying that, never finished. And that was, success is when you live on your own as you wish. And if this is the definition of success, then I pretty live like that life, nice life. When I'm not a targeted individual, when I'm not under microwaves, and especially when I'm not under direct energy attack, my life is excellent. I eat good food, I live in a nice place, as you can see, I have enough space. There is this also room upstairs I don't use at all, and two toilets and blah. And I need only one, my cat as well, he also uses mine. And he's there, but I'm not gonna, you know, he's shy. So. And what is the definition of the alpha male, beta male? This is regarding my ex-friend Biserka. She was repeating me always two things. You're a beta male and who gives a shit about you because you're broke. And she was quote-unquote alpha female. Very intelligent, very beautiful, not so wise. And one of those girls which was changing guys as a socks and always complaining how can she find that exactly guy she wants. Or she finds it, but then it's not that, she wants something else. So that being said, alpha, do you have to be 6'2" or 182 centimeters to be alpha, or it's mine 177 enough? Is alpha about success? Because if I understand success, success is when you work for the system, right? Then you have these little privileges, like this army and police officers in the area, which can easily open business and have all permissions, plus their regular job, and they don't even go to it. Okay, so is this success? Well, you know what? If you're buying this bullshit, then you're really mind controlled, because this is exactly the very first reptilian program they do on your brain, on your mind, which is the program of the impotence. Now stop buying this bullshit. If you have a soul, then you are not a beta male or beta female. You're super alpha. Thing is, you simply have to awaken it. I'll give you just a few examples. Tiger mango. Meow, 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 meow. So, a couple of days ago, I am by the Mekong River, where I like to chill out, beautiful energy. Mekong is my best friend here. And three young Khmer, it's like 9 p.m. drinking beer and standard Chinga Chok Farang Bo song, Farang Chok, blah blah blah, Ratanakiri. I start shouting, okay, shut up. They start shouting back. I go up, fix my bamboo stick at front, and like grab the guy for the hair. Ah, you're a funny guy, huh? You wanna bullshit more? Shut the fuck up. And then he goes, and then. And then when I moved away, again, I said, listen, dude, if I come second time, I'm gonna cut your throat. And then he shut up. And hey, guys, I don't really know who's the owner of this car, but it quite frequently parks his car, as you can see, how far away from the place where I live. I mean, literally sleep. And yeah, this is of course so part of the territory I rent, and he's not the neighbor. I know this neighbor. He has car here, and he's totally okay. During the day, he parks it here, for the sun reasons. But this guy, and I have a story, and this story is whenever he comes, he throws down. Remarks, Farang this, Farang that. Now, some simply imagine that. wherever you live, from the, let's say, let's count. So he's like sending remarks when he's leaving car, let's say here, but his car is parked here. Let's say how many my steps from my head. 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. So imagine 4 steps from your head. 1, 2, 3, 4. You have a guy parked and who has some comments on you. Hey, do you know who's the guy? Do you know who's the guy? Your friend?
No.
Boom boom?
No. Massage.
Massage, huh?
Yeah, massage.
Ah, sake sake. Only sake sake. Only sake sake. Okay. Yeah, all the way from Phnom Penh. Okay, yeah. So I would like to check out who is he. I noticed that he's sometimes commenting me.
Hello?
Yeah. Is it true? Does he sometimes comment me? Farang this, Farang that. Of course you don't know nothing.
No.
Of course. Why, how could you know anything? Okay, good. Yeah, good. Thanks. So, yeah, of course, a guy who works for the pimp doesn't know a jack shit. That's how it goes. And I'm gonna check out who's the guy, because I really would like to know. So what do we have here? Classical fucking game. By parking scooters and shit in front of my doors. Then they sit by their shit and then they comment my shit. Is this yours?
No. No, 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 no.
I live there.
No, no. Yo. No.
Aide, move it away. Aide, aide. Yes, yes, yes.
No!
Aide, Brownie, fuck off. Fuck off, Brownie. Aide, go. Aide. Go to your people, right? Go.
Oh, I thought but.
What's your problem? My house. Stop, please stop harassing
no!
me in front of my house.
You are crazy?
No, this is my house. You are keep on harassing me in my house.
No.
Yes,
no,
this
no,
is
no.
where I live. Please stop hanging out in front of my house and calling my name. Please move away. See, this is called bog. This is called bog. This is group harassment of one person. And it's normally accompanied.
Yeah.
Thank you. Bye bye. Could you please move away from your bike? Away from my
door. You came with you?
Please go away.
No, no.
Yes, you can.
Yeah, okay. Chop thot ba nay. Tên nó vinh.
Aide, let's go. Aide, let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
Aide, let's go.
Okay.
Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Huh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 little gooks. And nobody
okay.
can fight one white
no,
man.
No. Let's go.
Thank you. Bye bye. Go eat some rice. Drink some beer. I normally win. My dear drunk.
Why?
Because you're in my house.
No. I
leave my fucking phone alone.
You want to kill me?
No, I'm just defending myself. You are drunk, uninvited in my house. And I don't like you.
You don't say like that.
Oh, my friend. You never enter a Croatian's house uninvited.
You don't say like that. It's
no.
not good.
Well, let's face it. You are in my house, you fucking baboon, and you are uninvited.
You want me to live in your house?
You are in my house.
I know. I come to your house because I think that you are a relationship.
What?
You are a friend.
Am I afraid?
You friend, not a friend.
I'm me your friend. Fucking never.
Oh, so
never.
After tomorrow, you don't need my friend.
We were never friends.
You never be friends?
Of course. You when I came first day, you attacked me verbally. Then you lied to me that your massage salon is not a fucking brothel, which it is, and you are the pimp.
Okay.
And then small things started to disappear. And in the meantime, I had to enjoy your drunken behavior and your fucking whores. Therefore, we are not of the same level, neither of the same race. Baboon!
Your duck.
My duck is cleaner than any of you people.
Okay. It's your house. It's my house.
Absolutely.
Yeah, your duck is on my house.
And this is my diplomacy.
Do not take your duck on your my house. If I see your duck, I will kill you.
Ah, this was a threat for my poor little duck. Me no good, you just invaded my house. You see, this is how it goes with them. When they invade your house and start threatening you, you are not good because this is their country, Nia Kampuchea. Welcome to the neighborhood, my friend. Welcome to the neighborhood. That rat today, only as the beginning of the story and blah, 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 blah. This is how you live it, this is some shit. I'm just gonna give you one short story. Soul superiority. I am in Phnom Penh. I have 60 kilos. I have several problems. My biggest problem is the E. coli superbug infection, which is it's killing me. Doctors gave me 2 weeks of life. One doctor 7 days, one doctor 14 days. And they offered me therapy of the beta-lactamines melanoma for $2,500. That was Dr. Sreng Sorotea in Calmette Hospital. It was in March 2015. And I was in really bad shape. And they told me, you know, your next phase and this final phase is gonna be, you're gonna have fever. That means when E. coli finally migrates into the blood and then you have sepsis. This is normally, this is next phase. It can kill you in other ways, but it's burning. You know, it produces acid. So my asshole is burned. I have to disinfect it with the alcohol because it's burned because of the acid. Same goes with peeing. Okay, I'm in final phase. So my intuition tells me when I finally got the money from my money and I went to the hospital, like I just turned to go to the house and take my bags, and she just stopped me and said no. And that wouldn't work. I know that antibiotic, now we know it doesn't work. And it just pushed me to buy marijuana, to make marijuana oil, and that saved me. But it took from March 2015 to the January 2016 to do it. Because it can calcify, it can stay dormant many months, that bacteria, and then open. So that's why you need to take it many months. And it's super bug. It's the best design to kill you, okay? And it saved my life. Second thing, I was really heavily microwaved where I lived. It was really very, very, very much worse than here. It was like constant, really constant. And I had like, still folio, just now when I remember that. So it literally in meditation, it was intuition, the God, we call it God, I call it truth, love, and my soul, and then my consciousness, right? So it was like pointing me on a map where I exactly need to go in Cambodia, which was a little bit off of the Taveng. I never went to that area because it's not safe. It's really not safe. But I stayed in Taveng, in that area. It's like deep into jungle, the poorest region of the Cambodia. Ratanakiri, and the poorest part of that region, the last outpost. After that, no more police station, nothing, just local communities and national park in Laos, okay? Like 30 kilometers away from Laos, 70 kilometers away from Vietnam. So, I lived there. I lived there 6 months, and I recovered from E. coli, largely mostly there. I was fit to work, and I started to work in that school where I was one of the best. I worked like 6 months until first bullshit. And in short, the intuition saved me. I was not microwaved in Taveng. I slept like a baby. I only had locals to harass me, nothing more than that. House invasions, that's it. And energy was excellent, prana was good. I live. Look at me, I'm fat and happy. So how about that? Is that success? Huh? When you play against the system, when you play against the odds, with $2,000 you save your life from Superbug. People die from that. Thousands and thousands of people die per year from Superbugs. I heard like a number of 200,000 people died. So Coli was one of them, I think, on the second place. So it killed many people. It didn't kill me. What is success? What is alpha male? Don't fall for the ego trips. If you're sold and if you finally figure it out that you can dominate other people, either simply mentally or physically if it's needed, because you're to that degree awakened, always listen to your intuition and never hurt anybody and try to help others to get to that point. That's my point. And success is not defined by their categories, because their categories are bullshit. What if right now two reptiles walk in, start beating me, raping me, skinning me and eating me? Does it make me a loser, or does that simply make the whole fight very uneven? I'm talking about unfair fight. Huh? Okay, let me challenge the destiny. What if money comes in my life? What will I do? Will I be able to open successful business? Without obstacles? Bah! What a funny question.